As discussed in the previous class, as there are a number of reforms, the changes took by the government of India in relation to the agriculture. To improve the agriculture production, government of India, it initiated a number of the reforms, the changes in agriculture, the technical and institutional reforms, the technological and institutional reforms. The reasons behind that such kind of reforms was the subsistence nature of Indian agriculture. In our country, agriculture basically has produced for a subsistence at a smaller in scale to the traditional methods of farming. So what were the reasons responsible for the initiation of such reforms, the technical and institutional reforms by the government of India, in which as a first has some monsoonal nature. Most of the agriculture has depended upon the rain. Agricultural practices are dependent on a rain. Agriculture, which is dependent on a rain, that's why the farmers reproduce as a low graded of materials comparatively the other areas of the world. Second, as a subsistence nature of farming. Subsistence, mostly as an agriculture, first, dependence on a rain. Second one is a subsistence. Subsistence nature of a farming. Mostly farmer, they produce the crops at a smaller agriculture field for their survival or either as their needs of their family or the localities. Neither they prefer for the commercial farming. That's why as the reforms required to which as we can increase as a production. Third one, as a most number of the farmers, these were the poorers. Farmers were the poorers and they hold as a smaller land holdings. Due to as a smaller agricultural fields, smaller land holdings, they can't make possible changes for the cash crops. So for which as they need to the increase the surface area of the agriculture fields, for which as a collectivization was initiated by the government of India. Then the fourth one as a lack of the machinery, the lack of the mechanization and dependence on animals, which leads to the production as a small scale comparatively the commercial farming. And mostly as agriculture in our country, at the time of independence or before of independence, it was as only as a food crops. They emphasize over the food crops, neither for the earning of a profits. They just produce the goods for the survival, neither for the earning of profits. So for which as a number of reforms initiated in Indian agriculture, which provides a livelihood for the more than 60% of people as directly and indirectly. Directly in the sense, those which are directly engaged in agriculture sector. Farmers or landless laborers, which are also getting their employment directly from the agriculture. Indirectly, in the sense, those activities which are allied to the agriculture. For example, agro-based industries. Industries obtain their raw material from the agriculture like jute industry, sugar industries. So these are the indirect sector. Jaggery formation, jaggery manufacturing, then as the dairy farming, fishing. So all these are collaborative. They are the supportive to the agriculture. So indirectly, more than 60% of people, they engage, they earn their livelihood from the agricultural sector. Mostly as such reforms, these reforms were needed for a generation of employment in a country. So the number of reforms which we discussed in a previous class as the land reforms, government of India initiated as a land reforms, in which as they abolished the zamindari system, they allotted the land to those which were as a landless. Government has given as an allocation of a land to those which were the refugees which came after the partition of India towards our country.